more trading news coming at your way. In the last 2 days, I'm going to be explaining all of the big trades that have went down as of yesterday and as of today. I'm going to be going over later in the video the big trade names such as David Price and Cole Hamels moving on, and Kansas City looking to add something. But the real question is, Toronto really trying to win it all this year? All coming up for you. Anyway, getting into the video, Kansas City made a trade. I think it's probably most likely going to be their last one. They traded for, They traded for Oakland A's utilityman Ben Zobrist. I think that's a good pickup for them. I think Ben Zobrist brings a lot to the table. He can play any position on the defensive side of the ball. He could play second base, shortstop, outfield, any part of the outfield. I think it's a good pickup for Kansas City when you consider they still have the injury to Alex Gordon. But Jerod Dyson, he's doing okay out there in left. I know Dyson hasn't got much playing time, but when he does, you know, you got to tip your hat to him. He's a good outfielder because he's got such great speed. But adding a guy like Ben Zobrist could really help, because Omar Infante is really struggling this year. I have to say the biggest trade, and it's probably going to be the two thumbnails, is David Price from Detroit got traded to the Toronto Blue Jays for Daniel Norris and 3 prospects. David Price now going to Toronto. Toronto is basically doing a carbon copy of what the Oakland Athletics did a year ago. And, well, for Toronto's sake, they're just hoping that that carbon copy won't be the exact full copy, as we saw Oakland made all those trades when they had the best record in the American League, and they went from the best in the American League to just barely winning the second wild card, and then they would end up getting eliminated in the wild card round to Kansas City at tail end of the season. To be honest with you, I'm really shocked by Toronto's second biggest move in the last 48 hours, or I should say 36, maybe even 24 if you really want to narrow it down. Toronto already shocked the baseball world when they made a blockbuster deal that got them Troy Tulowitzki. But then when they added a pitcher in which they needed a pitcher in David Price, they got exactly what they needed, getting David Price from the Detroit Tigers. So that was a really good pickup for the Toronto Blue Jays. And the second biggest part, Cole Hamels going to the Texas Rangers. I don't know, for whatever reason, many people believe Texas still has a shot for that wild card. A lot of people think, you know, Cole Hamels has a lot to provide for them. But I don't think Cole Hamels has it. I don't think... I think Texas may have given up too much. I think that was a stupid idea to trade for him. But obviously, I still think it was also the same situation on David Price. I feel like both Toronto and... I just fucking said their name. Toronto and Texas gave up a lot to get two pitchers. And in this case, I know David Price is a 2-month rental, not like Troy Tulowitzki. Tulowitzki, I did look it up yesterday, he has a contract still that he signed with the Rockies back in 06. And Tulowitzki's contract doesn't end till 2020 with a, I think, a fifth-year option in 2021. But Toronto also gets to keep that contract, so he's basically already locked up with the Blue Jays for the next 5 to 6 years. So there you go for Troy Tulowitzki. I still think David Price isn't going to stay with Toronto after, you know, Toronto's season's over. I don't think he'll stay unless, you know, they win the World Series. But I don't think he'll stay. Cole Hamels. I feel like Cole Hamels might be the same thing. I think Cole Hamels will want to go to a winning team like the Giants or like the Cardinals or something. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think Cole Hamels will go to a team that wants, or a team that's great when it comes to winning. And then the latest trade, like last night with the Mets and the Brewers involving Carlos Gomez and what the Mets did to Wilmer Flores, y'all got me fucked up, Terry Collins. How could you do that to a player that was reportedly being traded and then you put him out on the field when he's bawling his eyes out? You got me fucked up. That is by far the most demented thing I have ever seen in watching my years of baseball. Never, and that's the number one rule, folks, in baseball. Never put a player on the field or in the batter's box, especially if he's being traded. Because what is the rule when a player's traded? That's right. That's right. They take him out of the game. No. Terry Collins put him in? Terry Collins kept him in the game? That was stupid. Anyway, Carlos Gomez, he's still on the move. Carlos Gomez, along with pitcher Mike Fiers, goes to the Houston Astros for 4 minor league prospects. To the Houston Astros. The Astros think they can make a deep run. And the thing about the Houston Astros is they're an interesting team, to say the least. Houston got off to such a marvelous start. They obviously still are the story of baseball this year, because now they have, I think, if I'm not mistaken, I think they completed a sweep of the Angels. I think they just won. Yeah, they just won. It showed up they won 3-0. I don't know how they won. I think it was on a walk-off homer. Because Gregerson was pitching in the ninth. It showed up as Luke Gregerson. And normally in a tight game, they make the closer come on so that they don't, the other team doesn't have a chance to score. But anyway, not to get off sidetracked, Carlos Gomez is going to the Astros, and Wilmer Flores is staying with the Mets. Now, the Mets are by far livid with the team right now. I don't think there is any other fan base in all of professional sports. In all of professional sports, I don't think any fan base hates their team more than the Mets fans. Okay? But obviously, the big headlines were David Price going to Toronto one day after Toronto acquired Troy Tulowitzki, and then Cole Hamels going to Texas. Wilmer Flores finds out he's not being traded, and then Carlos Gomez, along with a pitcher named Mike Fiers, is going to the Houston Astros. Now, that concludes this edition of MLB Trade Deadline. I will keep you guys up to date as much as I can. I'll also keep you in touch on Chicago White Sox pitcher Jeff Samardzija. Most likely he's not going to be going anywhere because the White Sox are playing really well. But anyway, I thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked the video, hit the like and the subscribe button below. And I'll catch you guys up to date as soon as I can. And I'll upload the videos as fast as I can. And always remember to keep it cool, keep it classy. I love you all. And until the next video, ladies and gents, boys and girls, stay safe. Have a good one.